Hello, welcome you to the world of resource wealth of India. Today, we are going to discuss about the fiber crops and beverage crops. Cash crops are divided into fiber crops, beverage crops, spices and other crops. In this activity, we discuss about fiber crops and beverage crops. Cotton and jute are the major examples of fiber crops. Tea and coffee are the examples of beverage crops. First of all, we discussed about cotton cultivation and cotton textile industries. Cotton growing regions in India as well as the cotton textile industrial centers are shown in this map. What are the suitable conditions for the production of cotton? Frost-free growing seasons, 20 degree to 30 degree Celsius of temperature, as a small amount of annual rainfall are the geographical requirements of cotton cultivation. Suitable soil for cotton cultivation are black soil and alluvial soil. Why cotton is called universal fiber? Do you know? Cotton is used worldwide in textile sectors. So, cotton is known as a universal fiber. India ranks fourth in cotton production. The largest agro-based industry in India is cotton textile industry. The first cotton textile mill was established at Fort Gloucester near Kolkata in the year 1880. Mumbai is the most important cotton textile center in India. So, the city is termed as a cottonopolis. What are the reasons for Mumbai to become the most important cotton textile center? The reasons are easily availability of raw materials from neighboring regions and cheap availability of power, export and import possibilities of the Mumbai port, fresh water availability, human resource availability, etc. are the reasons. Next to Mumbai, Ahmedabad in Gujarat is a major cotton textile center. The other cotton textile industrial center in India from the map are Pune, Rajkot, Aurangabad, Hooghly, Mumbai, Thoothukudi, Tirunelveli, Mysore, Chennai, Coimbatore, Salem, Nagpur, etc. The other fiber crop is jute. Now we discuss about jute production and jute farming and jute industries. Jute is another fiber crop in India. Hot and humid conditions are ideal for its growth. High temperature and rainfall about 150 centimeters is essential for jute cultivation. Soil required for the cultivation of jute is well drained, alluvial soil. Most cultivated area of jute is the Ganga Brahmaputra Delta regions of West Bengal. The states of India to cultivate jute are the West Bengal, Assam, and some parts of Odisha. Jute and jute products from India are really significant in the international trade. What is the reason? Because jute has low cost and the rank second in food production among the world. Now we can discuss about beverage crops. Tea and coffee are the examples of these beverage crops. The most usable beverage crop is tea. India is the largest producer of tea in the world. Assam, West Bengal, Kerala, Tamil Nadu are confined to tea plantations. Hill slopes having an annual rainfall range of 200 to 250 centimeters and 25 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius of temperature are most favorable for tea plantations. Well-drained soil rich in humus conditions or contents is required for the plantation of crops. Tea is a major export commodity of India. Okay, The other beverage crop is coffee. India stands 6th in the producer of coffee. Coffee plantations of India are confined to the western Ghat ranges of Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Moderate temperature and high rainfall are the requirements of coffee cultivation. Arabica, high quality coffee seed which has a great demand in the international market. 2/3 of total production is from this Karnataka. Dear students, in this session we discussed about the different crops like tea, coffee, jute, etc. Let we meet in the next class. Thank you.